Hey guys, welcome back for another episode of Hawkeye Bass, and sorry for the delay in the upload. I think it's been like 8 or 9 days since I've uploaded. Been pretty busy. We had our little town like festival called Scandinavian Days. Here's some fireworks from that though, from the drone. And we just took that big trip, you know, fishing. If you guys haven't seen those like 4 or 5 videos I put out, go watch them. They're pretty top-notch fishing videos, and I put a lot of time into editing them, so go check those out. Today we're gonna be doing something a little bit different. It is super duper hot out. Like it's like over 100 degrees, feels like temperature. We're going to try to catch a fish on a 14-inch worm. Now the pond we're going to, that's probably the average bass size. So I think it's gonna be quite a challenge. If that doesn't work, you know, we're gonna go back to throwing Cinco, stuff like that. We're gonna catch some fish there. And then later tonight, I think me and a buddy are going to the river to do some catfishing and pretty much, well, anything that bites on the bottom. So this might kind of be all over the place, but I hope you guys enjoy. Hope I don't have a heat stroke, and let's go catch some fish. All you have to do is stay a minute, just take your time. The clock is ticking, so stay. All you have to do is wait a second, your hands on mine. Alright guys, so my wind cover of my GoPro just flew off, so I'm guessing the sound is pretty awful. But we're here now with the giant worm, and we're going to try to catch some fish. Alright guys, so here it is, the 14-inch squirming worm from Bass Pro Shops. Things are freaking giant. Throwing it with some braid today, Fimic HMX pole, and my Shimano Antares reel. Throwing this weightless because it weighs a ton. There we go. Let's see what it does. Pretty good, honestly. I might have to throw weight on there with this wind, though. All right. Now let's see if we can get some fish. Yeah, it doesn't sink very fast. All right, guys, we had our first bite on this big bad worm. Just not really ideal. Oh, there we go, we got him. My drag slip. Oh, it's a nice one. Holy crap. Sweet. Get up here. There we go, guys. I'm gonna switch you around so you can hear me talk maybe without this wind. First fish on the 14-inch worm. Pretty good one too. Hooked in the bottom. Ouch, he is just chomping down on me right now. All right, guys, so you see it? There's the 14-inch worm. It's probably a, I don't know, 16, 17-inch bass. Probably a 2.5, 3-pounder that I just dropped. All right, nice fish. We'll take it. All right, let's get him released. It's the first 14-inch worm fish of the day. Oh, we just missed another one, guys. Oh my gosh, that makes me so angry. Oh, I even let him take it a little bit longer too. Oh no, and that was a bigger fish too. I guess big baits, big bass today. He messed up my worm pretty good, I think. Oh yeah, there's a telltale sign that you had a bite. I'm lucky that I went weedless on this because this pond is really starting to get a pretty big bloom of weeds in here. But there we go, guys. Missed the second fish of the day. I didn't know if they'd be back in this kind of corner. This is a really shallow part of the pond. Like it's only like 6 foot pretty much all the way across me. It's like, you know, up to 18 foot over there. And it's been so dang hot. I thought they'd be a little deeper today, but well, at least those two weren't too deep. We just missed another one. Look at that. And I left him in the car. Something just got the tail of this worm. I'm gonna go back to the car, grab the pack. We're gonna put a new one on. We're gonna catch some more fish in this. I'm pretty confident now. All right, guys, we're back with the big old worms. It is so dang hot. Look at those things. These things are just so ridiculous. Never done anything like this in my life. So I'm rigging them a little further back, probably about an inch back here. Get that up on the hook. Get that through. There we go. Jeez, I gotta turn the camera on because I was having a bite. Look at,
It took the freaking ribbon tail right off the end. Okay, so we know that's a fish grabbing the tail. And it had some weight too. It's not like it was a little bluegill. I mean, that was a pretty hefty feeling fish. I'm gonna cast one time without the ribbon, but I think that ribbon gives it a pretty unique motion. So I'm gonna put a new one on here after this cast. Let him take it a little bit and then boom, got him. Fish number two. Not nearly as big as the last one. Okay, so now you guys will be able to get a pretty darn good size comparison here. I hate those red wing blackbirds. They like dive on me. Look at that, that bird is gonna dive on me. All right, so here's a 14 inch worm, as I've probably said 50 times in this video now. And let's put it up to this bass. All right, hope you guys can kind of see that. This fish is right around 14 inches, so this is the same size as this fish, a 14 inch fish, but. All right, we got a bite. Oh, nope. He was on there and he just messed up my worm. Really hard to time your hook set, guys, especially like the first one just crushed it right away, you know, but. Oh, did one come hit it on the way in? One hit it when I was ripping it in. It's really hard to judge the hook set because I've had some fish grab it down here, and I've had, you know, traditionally bass will eat, you know, their prey head first, but man, I'm having problems with the timing here because these fish keep kind of going opposite each time. One came out and grabbed it when I was burning it in. There's one. Oh, another like 14 inch fish. Actually, this one might even be, I think this one's smaller than the 14 inch worm. That's pretty darn funny. Yeah, that's definitely smaller. This is like 12 inch fish. Been on that 13 inch worm. This is kind of fun. Pretty hilarious. There you go, buddy. Oh gosh. Good hook set and everything. They're liking this 14 inch worm. I'm just worried I found a little school of smaller fish out there. As you can tell, that one was more than likely biting the tail and just kind of run with it. I mean, I even let that fish run with it for quite a bit too. The big ones don't mess around very much. They just kind of grab by the head. Well, the only one big one I've caught today. The little ones seem to kind of grab the tail instead of the head. That time I was basically dead sticking out there for probably, I don't know, 20 seconds. And then I felt it come up. Oh, we got another fish on here. See, I don't know, right there. I was just about to set the hook. That fish, I could tell he just had the tail. There it is. Oh, it's a nice one. Another pretty decent fish, especially for this pond. Oh yeah. He came up and hit that right up by shore. Yeah, that's a good fish there. Probably another like 16 incher. Let me get you out of the wind to the best of my abilities here. Brought up a bunch of grass with them too. There's another pretty solid largemouth bass. Probably a 2.5 pounder, probably 16, 17 inches probably. Nice chunky guy too. These things are really fattening up again after the spawn. There's one. Oh jeez, get up here. Here's another probably 14 incher. Probably about the same size as the worm, but this is crazy, guys. I can't believe they are biting this so good. I was honestly kind of worried. I chose this pond because this is one of my ponds that's better for numbers, and there's a few decent ones, but that is so funny. There's a 14 inch fish caught with a 14 inch worm. Got that. Oh no, that fish, guys. I wish I would have been recording. I was just lifting the worm out of the water. Nice fish, biggest one of the day so far, probably about a solid 3 pounder. Came up, drilled it, took the whole worm, gone. Oh man, literally took it right when I was lifting it out of the water. All right guys, so we are down to 3 left. All right guys, so we are down to 2 left. I just lost one when I was casting. It was getting a little beat up, thought I could get one more fish out of it. Flew off, got a giant backlash, you know how it goes. But yeah, we got 2 left. All right, let's see if we can get one right in front of these reeds. There's usually a fish. Oh, there was one sucking on the tail. Come on. Oh, come on. Screwed up my worm. This thing is hard to keep in good shape. Alright. There's a fish in front of these weeds right here. Oh, another one taking the tail and then left it alone. Standing right in these big old weeds here. I'm probably gonna get a tick on me. Oh, I saw him fall. Yeah, it was like a 10 inch bass and he just had the ribbon of this worm. Missed the fish. Missed another one. Look at, took the ribbon off. That is what is happening with these smaller bass that keep kind of checking this thing out. You guys will not believe the size of the frogs down here. I don't know if you guys can see, but right there is one giant frog, and there's another giant one right there. I don't really want to catch him because I don't like frogs, but nope, he didn't like the chatterbait. Do you? Oh my gosh, he does like the chatterbait. Oh my god. There, perfect, he fell off. Look at the size of that dang thing. Oh yeah, so pretty obviously I switched to a little chatterbait action. I'm leaving my last worm for down there that side of the pond.
Hey guys, so we pretty much finished up at that pond. Didn't get any more fish. I lost that worm on a fish right at the end. So we decided to head over to the river. It's about just about 8 o'clock, so we have about an hour. Hoping to get some smallmouth, maybe a catfish, and who knows what else. I'm gonna start out by throwing a craw. Then I'm also gonna have a night crawler on the bottom, hopefully to catfish or a big carp, you know, whatever will bite on the bottom. So we're gonna get down there and try to make this a little longer of a video for you guys, try to get some different fish on here. I got some good feedback on my multi-species videos, the last ones when we were up in Iowa Falls in the river up there. So we're gonna try to make this a multi-species video for you guys, but I hope you guys enjoyed the first part of this video with that 14 inch worm. That is crazy. And another thing I want to say real quick, guys, I'm going to do a giveaway of 14 inch worms, maybe a pack or two, if this video can hit 50 likes. So let's get on that, guys. Give this video a thumbs up. Let's go hit the river now.
Fish on, guys, at the dam. Largemouth again. I keep getting these largemouth down here. Definitely going for smallmouth on a little craw there. This is all I've been catching down here. A little chunky little largemouth. What? No, you're fine, you're fine. There goes that little guy there.
All right guys, so we are back at the house now. The river just was not producing tonight, which I was pretty upset. I tried probably three different spots. I threw craws, I threw some twister tails, threw a Ned rig, basically threw the whole kitchen sink at those smallmouth and they were not cooperating today. Kind of ran out of time as well. Also, shout out to Randy, one of my subscribers that flagged me down today at the river, noticed my truck and me. Got to fish with him for a little bit, good guy. We'll see you around again, Randy. But anyways, that's pretty much the day, guys. I had a lot of fun doing this challenge with the 14 inch worms. Let's get this video to 50 likes and I'll give away a pack for you guys at home to try to catch your own fish on those crazy, crazy baits that I intend to use a little more regularly now because they were pretty darn good. I can't wait to take them to some of my places where I can catch some bigger fish on them. So anyways, that's all I got for you guys today. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Don't forget to like this video. We'll see you guys later.
Waiting for the time to pass you by. Hope the winds of change will change your mind. I could give a thousand reasons why. And I know you, and you've got to make it on your own, but we don't have to grow up. We can stay forever young. Living on my sofa, drinking rum and cola underneath the rising sun. I could give a thousand reasons why, but you're going, and you know that. All you have to do is stay a minute, just take your time. The clock is ticking, so stay. All you have to do is